Welcome to Mozat's New World Empire. My name is T-Strings and your tutor for today, Mozat. Today, we'll be discussing about the guitar open chord on key C. Stay tuned and keep learning.
Oh, guys, I'm excited. Guitar, we want to apologize for skipping your classes last week. That is because we just got our new studio and we took our time to set it up for you. Okay, today we want to quickly look at guitar chords, open chords, specifically talking about the key C. Okay, I don't just want to teach you the chords, I want to relate everything to key C as if you're already playing your songs on key C. The last time Gamania Gosbread took you guys on the general music class, where he taught you how to bring out the chromatic scale of all the keys and how to bring out the diatonic scale of all the keys, thereafter bringing out your first note, the third note, and the fifth note, which gives you the triad chord. Okay, if you missed that class, check in the links right here, right now. So if we look at key C, for example, those of you that did the assignment, the notes of the key C is C, D, E, F, G, A, B, and C. That gives you the Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do of key C. Now, if you look at key D, the notes of the diatonic scale notes of the key D is D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C sharp, and D. For key E, the major scale of key E, the notes are E, F sharp, G sharp, A, B, C sharp, D sharp, and E, and so on and so forth. Just to recap, go and pick every note of the chromatic scale, write it down, then pick the formula, home key, jump a tone, jump another tone, pick the next note, which is a semitone, jump a note, jump another note, jump another note, pick a semitone. So it becomes home key, tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone. When you bring it out from the chromatic scale, it gives you the notes of the diatonic scale. Then, from the notes of the diatonic scale, you now pick the first note. You number it 1 to 7, which is your Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. You number it 1 to 7. Pick the first note, pick the third note, and pick the fifth note. That is what we're going to use for our chord. Then, I taught you, you go to your guitar, you draw your guitar. When you draw the notes of your guitar, you now begin to, you know the notes of the guitar according to the class we did on the guitar fretboard. So you pick those notes and then you begin to trace it on the board and then you circle it first come, first serve. Okay, I believe you got that class. If you didn't get it, check in that link below and then you know how to, you know, draw out the notes of the key of every chord you desire to play. Now, talking about key C, the notes of the key C is C, D, E, F, G, A, B. Okay, so if we want to relate it in solfas, you now discover that your C will give you your Do, your D will give you your Re, your E will give you your Mi, your Fa will be your key F, your Sol will be your key G, your La will be your key A, and your T will be your key B. Now, talking about chords, you are going to, that means what you're going to do is that you're going to bring out key C, major scale, you bring out key D, major scale, key E, major scale. Every note of the key C, you bring out their own diatonic scale. Because you are not going to be, if it was a scale you just want to play, it means you just go ahead and just, you only need C, D, E, F, G, A, B. But now you need C chord, you need D chord, you need E chord, you need F chord, you need G chord, you need A chord, you need B chord, and you need C chord. So since you need them not as a note, you now have to go to every note and begin to bring out the chord of that note. Now the problem is, are you bringing out the major of that note or you are bringing out the minor of that note? If you are bringing out the major, why? If you are bringing out the minor of, how do you know whether it's D minor you're supposed to play or D major? Since it is the Re. Now, key C is the Do of key C as a center, as a root note. Now, D is the Re. And then in music, Re is a minor. where you want to play it as a chord. Mi is a minor, where you want to play it as a chord. Fa is a major, where you are playing it as a chord. Sol is a major, where you are playing it as a chord. La is a minor, where you are playing it as a chord. And T is a diminished, where you are playing it as a chord. Alright, so if you look at it, what we are going to look for in key C, I need C major chord, since it's my Do. I need D minor chord, since it's my Re. I need E minor chord, since it's my Mi. I need F major chord, since it's my Fa. I need G major chord, since it's my Sol. I need A minor chord, since it's my La. And I need B diminished chord, since it's my T on my key, which is key C. Okay, so somebody is singing on key C, and you are supposed to play the guitar on key C. You are supposed to know C major, D minor, E minor, F major, G major, A minor, and B diminished. That's what I want to show you now. So, we've taught you how to bring out the notes of the diatonic scale, and then now you just bring out the diatonic scale of key C, key D, key E, key F, key G, key A, and key B. Circle the first, circle the third, circle the fifth. You bring them out, go to your guitar and draw them. And then once you draw them, you'll be able to play it. Okay, so if we're to play it on the key C, C major chord is made up of C, E, and G. Now, this is my guitar right away. So I need to bring out key C, E, and G and begin to place my finger on them. We have taught you the strings. This is string 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Your first string is your E string. Your second is your B. Your third is your G. Your fourth is your D. Your fifth is your A. And your last, which is 6, is your E strings. Now I'm looking for C, E, G. So anywhere I can find C or E or G on these strings, I just mark it for myself. So I'm looking for E. C, E, G. Already I have E, so this is open. Once I pick a note, I leave the rest. I move to the next one. This is my A, Abby. Yes. This is A. I'm looking for C, E, G. So I pick A sharp, B, and what? C. So I have my note here on C. Once it's on my third fret, I use my third, this finger. I use my ring finger. Index finger for this, middle finger for the second fret, your ring finger and your little finger like this. So you just place it like this. So the first string is open, so I'm not touching it. It's an advantage for me. The second string is A sharp, B, and C. So I put my ring finger there. The third string is my D. D sharp, E. I have E already, so I put this here. This one is G. G strings is already open, so I don't need to bother myself because I already have G. And then this is my B strings, which is my second string, is B. So after B, I have C. So already my finger is going to be on C. This one is already E. So I have everything is settled. This is open, which is my E. This I'm pressing here, which is my C. I'm pressing here, which is my E. I'm leaving this open, which is my G. I'm pressing here, this here, which is my C. And I'm leaving this open, which is my E. So C major chord, this is now your C major chord. Okay. So I'm playing key C as a chord. All right, so that is for that. So let's go to Re now, which is your D. And since it's a Re we're looking for, is a minor we are looking for. For D, if you arrange the diatonic scale of D, you have it as D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C sharp, and D. So I pick the first, which is my D, I pick the third, which is my F sharp, and I pick the fifth, which is my A. Okay, what I now have is I need to flatten the F sharp, which gives me my F. So I'm looking for D, F, and A. We are looking for D, F, and A. I've explained this. So you now go as C. We're looking for D. So I start from here again. This is my E. F. I have F. So I'm okay with this. So I put my finger here on F. The next string is my string A. And I'm looking for D, F, A. I already have A. Advantage is open. So I leave it open. The next string is my D strings. and I already have D. Wow. D is open, so I leave it open. The next string is my G. G, I need D, F, or A. So I begin to go from G, G sharp, A, I have A. So A is very good. So I have my finger here. Don't forget I picked this before. Now I picked this. Now, so I go to my B strings and I'm looking for D, F sharp and what? A. D, F and A. So I pick it from B, I have C, C sharp and D. This is your D. So you put your finger here. Don't forget I still have my finger here and I have my finger here. If you draw it, it will be better for you. So if you now pick your E, we're looking for F. You have here as F. So I have my finger here. I pick my F here. I pick my D here. And I pick my G, G sharp and A here. So I pick my A here. Here is open because it's my D strings. Here is open because it's my A strings. Here is F. Of course, since it's only the string that is taking me up far and I'm jumping too open, I can decide to just ignore that. And then I will strum from my fifth string. So that gives me my D minor chord, which is my re on key C. Now, the next thing is, the next note on the major scale of key C is E, which is our Mi. And since it's Mi, we're looking for E minor. E minor will give me my Mi chord on key C. So I'll pick E and bring out the major scale of key E, circle the first, third, and fifth. Flatten the third gives you a minor. So it becomes E, G, G, and B. E, G, and B. E, G, B is what we're looking for. So you go ahead and trace it, trace it, trace it. By the time you trace it, what will it give you? That is your E minor. The reason it's E minor is because this guy is E. We have E already, so it's open. This guy is your A. If I trace it down, I have A sharp, and what? B, which is my, and I'm looking for E, G, B. I have B already. Then here is A, I mean D. I'm looking for E, G, B. So after D, D sharp, I have my E here, so which is correct. Then here is G. I'm looking for G, I don't need it. Here is B, I'm looking for B, I don't need it. Here is E, I'm looking for E, I don't need it. So the only note that is taking me into the fretboard is my, this fifth strings and my fourth string. If you now press it, it will give you your E minor chord. That is your Mi of key C. Now if you don't go to F, give me F major chord. Why am I playing F major? Why am I not playing F minor? I'm playing F major because I am looking for fa, relating it to key C. I'm looking for fa, and fa of any key is a major chord of that particular note. So you understand it. So that's your fa. Play this for me. Good. Don't forget you are pressing these two. You are pressing here. You are pressing here. So on string one, why are we pressing string one as F? Because if you check it, the notes, the diatonic scale of key F is F, G, A, B flat, C, D, E, F. So I'm picking the first, third, and fifth, which is my F, A, and C. I'm not flattening the third, so it remains my A. So I'm looking for F, A, C. I'm looking for F, A, C. So I pick my first note, which is my E, the E, F. So I'm pressing here. Here is B, C. I need C, I press here. Here is G, G, G sharp, A, I need A, I press here. Here is D, D, D sharp, E, and F, so that's why I'm pressing here. Here is A. If you must strum from here, then you must play the F full chord. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the next thing takes us to key G. Key G, the notes of key G is G, A, B, C, D, E, F sharp, and G. So what you do is that you circle your G, you circle your B, and you circle your D. And it's so we're looking for. So it means we're looking for G major chord. So G major chord, play it for me. Good. G major chord. So here is the G major chord. Please give me the G major chord. That's the G major chord You pick it from E, E strings, E, F, F sharp, G. Of course, we need G. Our finger is here. Then you pick your A, A, A sharp, B. We need G, B, C, G, B, D. That's what we need. So we have your B here. Then here is already D. We don't need to press anything. It's an advantage for us. Open. Here is G. We don't need it. It's advantage. Here is B. We don't need it. It's advantage. And then here is E, F, F sharp, and G. That's why you see this little finger holding down the G. So this ring finger on the third fret is holding down the G. This guy is holding down the B. Those ones are open, open, open. That's your D, G, and B is open. And then on this last note, this last strings, this little finger here is holding down the G. So that gives you the G major chord. Okay, the G major chord is your saw in solfège for your key C. And then the last one we're going to talk about is your A. A, if you pick A, we're looking for La on key C, talking about solfège. And La is a minor chord, like I said. So we're looking for the first note, the third note flattened, and the fifth note of A major scale. If you pick this first, you have A. If you flatten the third, you have C. If you pick the fifth, you have E. So I'm looking for what? A, C, E. Now, please, let me play your A minor chord. That's your A minor chord. All right, I'm looking for A, C, E. E is already done. Finish. E, I already have A. Wow. So this is open. This is open. So taking me to the four strings, the D strings, I'm not looking for D. So I start going down. D, D sharp, and what? D, D sharp, and E. So I have here, this guy is anchoring down my E. And then I go to my G. I'm not looking for G. So G, G sharp, and A. This guy is holding down my A. Then here, I have my B strings here. If I move down, I have my C. I'm looking for C. So I anchor it down. Here is E. I already have my E. So open, open, press your E here, press your A here, press your C here. So give me my A minor chord. Finish. And then the B diminished is something that I want you to skip for this class because you can always substitute your T. When we come to chord progression, hardly will you really, as a beginner, need to play T as a chord, which is a diminished chord. So I'll just leave that. So the chord, I've taught you how many chords today. Since I'm relating them to key C, and I have my C major as my Do, D minor as my Re, E minor as my Mi, F major as my Fa, G major as my Sol, A minor as my La. That's my Do, which is my C major chord of key C. Let's go to Re. Re is my D minor. Re. Re is my D minor, which gives me Re on relating it to my key C. Now, what of Mi? Mi. Which is my E minor. What of Fa? Which is my F major. What of Sol? Which is my G major. What of La? Which is my A minor. Let's go over it again. Let's recap. C major. Re, D minor, Mi, E minor, Fa, F major, Sol, G major, La, A minor. Okay, that is that about the open chords of key C. Next, we are going into chord progression and songs that can help you master key C. I hope we've helped you today to learn something. Okay, T strings, what do you have to say to your student? Because I'm done for today.
All right, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for your time. Hope you've learned a lot today. And please, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yes.
And hit the notification bell to be notified for more videos. Thank you so much. See you next week, Tuesday. Bye-bye. Bye.